Welcome in the 1920s, a time where the visual artists explored new ways of creativity and experimented with different materials and styles.
Hi, I'm Konstantina Orlandatou, and I'm coming originally from Greece, Athens. Before coming to Hamburg, that was in 2006, I was a composer in Greece. I was always curious about what happens if we involve different kind of media in the compositional process. So I started getting very interested in visual arts and how visual arts and music correspond to each other and what kind of differences exist between visual arts and music. Music, it's something that runs in time. So you have this kind of factor of time. You tell a story in a specific time frame. And I was thinking of what's the difference with the visual arts? And a painter, for example, narrates a story, but in a frame. What about, interacting with paintings? What about making paintings alive? And that was the first motivation to work in more detail in this topic, in this area. You have a really big benefit with virtual reality. You can create worlds that really don't exist. You can really make imaginary landscapes. You can make very, very creative kind of landscapes. And it was the perfect medium to make this vision that I had of jumping into a painting and then really have the opportunity to interact with the objects of the painting and then, of course, make music with them. The thing is that with VR, whatever you do in this virtual world, your body and your brain actually is going to simulate everything that happens there. So if you, for example, you are in a roller coaster in VR, in this virtual world, in a roller coaster, but you're standing in the physical room, in your physical world, you're still going to feel sick. You're still going to have this nausea feeling and you're bubbling in your stomach anyhow because your brain simulates this kind of experience. It's something that you always have to think when you're making experiences in VR, that you have to somehow find the good balance where your body, either in physical world or in the virtual world, says, okay, here we don't have any kind of discrepancy, everything it's fine. So the experience also pleasant for the user. It's a kind of, art mediation, but the interpretation that you see in this virtual world is my interpretation and how I see it from a composer's perspective. It's not that I do whatever I want to do, but for example, Vasily Kandinsky, we know he had his own theory of colors and sound. So I'm trying to take that into consideration in my own artistic process and try to translate from every painter the vision that he had with his painting. And sometimes it's very funny how people react that are coming from different kind of backgrounds. You see how visual artists react to what I'm doing, and you see how composers, or let's say musicians, react to what I do. Visual artists say, oh God, what you have done with the painting? I mean, you have break it down, you have made it into 1,000 pieces, why? Because they see it as an entity, and I really break it down to different kind of objects. Musicians, for example, have a total different experience. They enjoy it very much. They're not that much critical because they see it's a kind of creative thing that's happening there. And wow, you can use the painting as a music instrument. So you see different kind of experience, different kind of criticism, let's say. the feedback that I get, however critical they are, the people that they use it, they're really fascinated of this new medium and the possibility that this new medium brings with it.